I very much enjoyed this movie. I feel sorry for anybody who was sitting anywhere around me because I just wanted to dance.
Yeah, I love hearing that.
I'm curious. I mean, this is such a beautiful, magical film about the importance of family with so many characters, so much culture, so much great music, so much going on. What makes this film special to you? What does being part of Encanto mean to you?
I mean,
Look at us.
look at him.
First of all,
Look at
look at
that.
us. We get to be the main characters in Disney Animation's 60th film. Us.
Yeah, I mean, that's special right there. A
Yeah.
Latinx animated movie coming out for the holidays. When
Set
did
in
you ever
Colombia,
think?
like
Yeah.
what world are we living in? Oh, it
Oh,
turns out it's this one. We're living in it right now.
it's an
Wow.
inclusive world. Oh my God, that's so
It's
amazing.
really special.
And the movie's funny. It's the music is crazy. Her singing is unbelievable.
You.
And you fall in love with all these people, and you go, that's my family. I see my family in all these dysfunctional, beautiful folk.
Stephanie, what is that like for you? I mean, do you feel any sense of ownership of this character to where, like, if you go to a Disneyland theme park and see the character walking around, that you'll just feel like a special place in your heart for her?
I mean, listen, I've had a Disneyland annual pass for a very long time. I'm a huge Disney fan. I love Disney animation. It really holds a very like dear and special place in my heart. I had my bachelorette party at Disneyland, you know,
No,
like,
get
yeah,
out
I like did the whole thing. So like it's extremely special to me to be following the footsteps of some incredible, incredible performances throughout history of these Disney heroines. And like I hope that I've honored the legacy that they've left. I hope that I brought something new to the table. That's really all I can do is just try to honor what's gone before me and then hopefully bring my best to Mirabel. And like, hopefully, audiences will like her and go on the journey and the adventure with her.
At the same time, how do you embody a 15-year-old? Like, where did you find your inner inspiration for her?
Man, I mean, listen, when I was 15, when I was 15, it was like, I honestly do think adolescence for anybody, but particularly young women, is a really difficult time. You're sort of, you've got all these societal pressures, you've got internal pressures, your body and brain is changing at an incredible rate. You're way smarter than most people around you. Like 15-year-old girls are some of the smartest people I've ever
This
met.
is true. I have a daughter.
Right? Like it's like, oh my God, you're so bright and you're so, your worldview is so smart. How are you coming up with all this, you know? And like, and yet at the same time, like everything's shifting and changing for them. I remember that period of my life very, very, very well. And so I was able to sort of think about that and try to bring it to Mirabel because I think she's going through kind of the same thing.
John, how much fun is it to voice a character that we're not all, you know, all that sure of? We don't know really if he's a good guy or a bad guy. We just know that we're not supposed to talk about him. So, how did everyone else's reaction to him really sort of shape how you approach the character?
Well, it was mostly the directors, Byron and Jared, who steered me into this path of sort of being this really socially awkward, weird, loner who talks to his rats and mice, and they're his only friends. They just create a safe space for me to be as weird as possible, and to create this character that's kind of myself at my most awkward.
I love that this story is really, you know, the underdogs that save the day. It takes the two family outcasts to heal the cracks in
Weirdos
the
with power,
home. What do you think it'll mean to audiences to see that the ordinary really can do the extraordinary, and that if you're the odd one out, that you really do have something special to bring to the table?
Yeah, such a great message, isn't it? Yeah, I
Yeah.
think that's the most beautiful thing we can give at these holidays is there's a place for everyone, you know, and we just have to be patient with ourselves and inclusive of others. It's a beautiful message.
Yeah, I would add to that that I hope that if anyone is sort of watching this film and going, I don't know, I don't know if I can, I don't know if I'm valuable, I don't know if I'm worthwhile, I hope this film gives them a nudge in the direction of like you are extraordinary, even if you think you're ordinary. you just are, just by you being alive and being on the planet. You're extraordinary. Yes,
preach.
Well, Stephanie, you got to work with the music of Lin when you did In the Heights, but you really sort of kick things off in this by setting the whole tone for the movie with the song, The Family Madrigals. So what was that like to perform? What was it like to hear this music the first time?
It was amazing. I mean, Lin is such an incredible writer. He's really a genius. And some of these songs are such, I think the word is like earwig when it gets in your, maybe that's a bug though. Like, is an earwig a bug? I don't know. But like they get in your head. They like, there's a hook and they sort of stay and they sort of tumble around in your brain. And Lin's really, really good at doing that. He's really good at writing a hook. He's so smart. And the songs are so good and they're so funny and they're such good storytelling songs and they're structurally so interesting that as somebody who loves music and who loves especially musicals and Disney musicals, it was really, really fun to see the history of Disney musicals kind of reflected in these songs. Because like, if you're a Disney fan and you're paying attention, you can sort of see the structure of the songs over the course of the film is reflective of how other Disney films are structured too. And yet it's doing something totally new. It's really fun.
It's such a big family. There are so many fun characters in this. Aside from your own character, which other member of this family would you like to learn more about or see them go on their own adventure?
Oh, wow.
That's a good, I think I'd like to know more about Peppa.
The stormy weather.
Whose emotions affect the weather. I'd love to see like a day in the life of Peppa, what that would be like.
Yeah, that's a good one. Right? I like this, the strong sister.
Yeah, Luisa. Yeah.
I like to see a whole story of her, you know, changing the environment, fixing climate change, you know, who knows what she could do. But that kind of strength.
Maybe the two of them together.
Yeah, fix the whole world.
Were there any major changes along the way that were made to your character or the aspects of the story as you recorded this? Or do you feel like it pretty much stayed the movie you thought it was?
Well, my character changed. I was a little cockier when I started and tore me down till I was the most vulnerable, like a puddle. I was an emotional puddle. And then somewhere around there is where they created Bruno. But I started out a little more, you know, cockier. And then they go, no, a little more vulnerable, a little more awkward.
That's cool. I don't know. I mean, I don't think that the structure of the story really changed at all. Some of the songs did shift around, like structurally, some of the songs changed a little bit. Like,
what they saw and what the vision changed.
Yeah, like
a couple
there
times.
Was the vision change, like the storytelling elements sort of shifted, but no like big, like we've thrown your character out entirely, like that. Like now she's going to learn to sail a boat or fly a plane, you know, nothing like huge.
They didn't come to you and say, okay, now we're rewriting it and she's just not going to be in it anymore.
You've been cut out of the film. I mean, listen,
that happened
it happens.
Oh my God, John Wick 2, that's what happened to me. Oops, now it's not a time to talk about that.
I've had it happen before. I had a whole scene of fancy, like big scene cut because
John Wick 2 had a fight sequence and
a monologue.
And it's all like on the cutting room.
See you never.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys so much. It was delightful to talk to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.